A lot of this isn't going to make sense to you, and I'm sorry about that. I'm just going to start at the beginning with the house. I lived here until I was 11, but I wasn't allowed inside half the rooms. Inside the mailbox of bills from 7 years ago, marked urgent, open immediately. I hadn't been back since my brother Lewis's funeral. In a room, my mother left me a key but didn't tell me what it unlocked. Maybe she thought I'd know, or she thought the mystery would be enough to bring me back. I wanted to drift this way a long time, but I saw a few of prints. Even after I inherited the house, I never thought I'd come back to it. But now I have questions about my family that only the house has the answers to. The house was exactly like the way I've been dreaming about it. As a child, the house made me uncomfortable in a way I couldn't put into words. Now, as a 17-year-old, I knew what exactly those words were. I was afraid of the house. Crawling through the doggy door used to be a lot easier when I was 11. power had been turned off the night you left. For the first time in years, I felt like I was home. But instead of a family, there were just memories of one. Like how only one restaurant would deliver to our house, so we had changes a lot. The table was still a wreck from the night we left. It was like a bomb had gone off, killing everyone but sparing the furniture. My mom was the only one of us who could imagine Great-Grandma Eden living in a nursing home. Nothing in the house looked at me. There was just too much of it. Like a smile and too many teeth. Even the fireplace had a story. Edie told me the bricks came from the original house after it sank. Mom always told me to stay out of the basement, so I wasn't too surprised when the key didn't fit. Great-Grandpa Sven built music books for Barbara, along with the rest of the house. After Lewis started working at the cannery, we all got pretty sick of salmon. Except our cat, Molly. A lot of things got left behind in the whirlwind of that last night. After Milton disappeared, Mom sealed up all the bedrooms. Then Edie retaliated and drilled peepholes. I spent a lot of time playing in Great Uncle Walter's room. I think my mom sometimes regretted not sealing it up. Lewis told me there were secret passages, but I never believed him. Turns out, my mom is really good at keeping secrets. Now it was time to find out what I've been afraid of. From the paintings on the wall, it was clear my brother Milton had been here before me. Reading this, maybe it sounds like I had a plan. But I had no idea what was behind that door. Just like I had no idea where all this was gonna lead. Thank you. I grew up looking at Molly's room through the peephole. Molly's gerbil had a tiny bedroom with its own even tinier gerbil cage. Being inside for the first time, I felt like I'd stepped behind a painting.
December 15th, 1947. Dear Diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving, so I looked around for something to eat. The gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind. My Halloween candy was all gone. I kept eating and eating. I ate a lot of things that night. Then I heard chirping outside my window. It was a barn swallow going back to her nest. I reached out for her. Suddenly, I was a cat. I tried to be quiet, but the bird was really scared. I could tell she was getting really tired. Now I was up in a big tree. I promised that I wouldn't climb it anymore. All I cared about was eating at my room. I gobbled her up. And suddenly, I was an owl. First, a light was the wind. Then I heard little teeth nibbling in the grass. up, and I didn't choose anything. Then I flew off to find something bigger. A mama rabbit. She was almost too big to carry. I started choking, but I couldn't stop eating. And suddenly, I was a shark. Into the ocean. Now, I was hungrier than ever. Monsters and I smell it.